Today is a triumph for freedom, as huge as any victory that's ever been won on any battlefield. Today, we strike away the last major shackle of those fierce and ancient bonds. Today, the Negro story and the American story fuse and blend.
In the same room where President Lincoln signed the first Emancipation Order in 1861, President Johnson signed the 1965 Voter Registration Act and pledged to millions of Americans a new chance to find a political voice.
This law will ensure them the right to vote. The wrong is one which no American in his heart can justify. The right is one which no American, true to our principles, can deny.
With a battery of pens and before witnesses like Negro leaders Martin Luther King, Roy Wilkins, and James Farmer, who were watching the climax of the campaign to which they devoted years of will and energy, the president signed. President Johnson moved the next day to implement the bill. So far, the strongest link in the legislative chain, which the president titles the Great Society, the voting bill promises a profound effect upon the future politics of the entire nation. Inside the Army base at Oakland, California, a scene reminiscent of the recent past, the years of the Korean and World War II campaigns is reenacted by yet another generation of young Americans. In response to the stepped-up pressure of the communists in South Vietnam, the United States continues its arms buildup. Within weeks, 50,000 additional troops, with all of the materiel of war, will be committed, bringing the total of American forces in South Vietnam to 125,000. The tonnage handled by this one port is up 30% in just a few months. Troopers are arriving daily by train or plane from posts all over the nation. With weapons slung and duffel hefted to the shoulder, in most instances sore armed from a bewildering variety of inoculations, they arrive, young, proud, nervous with anticipation, but confident and well trained. For the fourth time in half a century, the United States will test its honor and its power in the flames of battle. President Johnson has reiterated U.S. determination not to abandon the people of South Vietnam. His calls for peace talks have gone unanswered, though diplomats have stalked the capitals of a dozen foreign nations seeking a formula to end the bloodshed. From Peking and Hanoi, the latest replies have been shrill with defiance. They pledge that if this buildup continues, they will hurl their armies into the mountains and jungles to support the Viet Cong. Hanoi commands over a million well-trained men who wait just over the 17th parallel. Behind them looms the uncountable horde of Red China. To counter the threat, the president has asked for a budget increase of $1.7 billion and an increase of battle-ready forces to nearly 3 million. So the buildup is on, and perhaps 60% of the total force will move from this shining San Francisco Bay under the Golden Gate to the far-off beaches of Southeast Asia.